गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे लेट अस लर्न अबाउट हाउ एंड व्हाई ऑफ ऑक्सीजन थेरेपी। इट्स अ फ्रेश आर्टिकल ऑन इंडियन एक्सप्रेस। अ ह्यूज डिमांड फॉर ऑक्सीजन हैज अंडरलाइंड इट्स इंपॉर्टेंस इन COVID-19 मैनेजमेंट। व्हाट हैपेंस इन द बॉडी दैट लीड्स टू सम पेशेंट्स नीडिंग ऑक्सीजन थेरेपी। व्हाट इज द प्रोटोकॉल फॉर सच थेरेपी। The ongoing second surge in COVID-19 cases has been a huge rise in the demand for supplemental oxygen. What makes the gas so vital in COVID management? When does a COVID-19 patient need oxygen support? A small proportion of COVID-19 patients need oxygen support when the shortness of breath progresses to a more acute condition. Most patients with COVID-19 have a respiratory tract infection, and in most severe cases, their symptoms can include shortness of breath. In a small proportion of such cases, this can progress to a more severe and systemic disease characterized by acute respiratory distress syndrome, ARDS. How does COVID-19 trigger shortness of breath? Shortness of breath occurs because of the way COVID-19 affects the patient's respiratory system. The lungs enable the body to absorb oxygen from the air and expel carbon dioxide. When a person inhales, the tiny air sacs in the lungs alveoli expand to capture this oxygen, which is then transferred to blood vessels and transported through the rest of the body. Respiratory epithelial cells line the respiratory tract. The primary function is to protect the airway tract from pathogens and infections and also facilitate gas exchange. And the SARS-CoV-2 can infect these epithelial cells. To fight such infection, the body immune system releases cells that trigger inflammation. When this inflammatory immune response continues, it impedes the regular transfer of oxygen in the lungs. Simultaneously, fluids too build up. Both these factors combined make it difficult to breathe. Low levels of oxygen triggered by COVID-19 are inflammatory markers, which include elevated white blood cell counts and neutrophil counts. Is India witnessing more patients with shortness of breath? Yes. Data with National Clinical Registry for COVID-19 shows a new emerging trend during the second wave. Shortness of breath is the most common clinical feature among symptomatic hospitalized patients at 47.5% compared to 41.7% during the first wave. Simultaneously, other symptoms have dropped significantly compared to the first wave. Dry cough 5-6% versus 1.5% in first wave. Loss of smell 7.7%. Fatigue 24.2%. Sore throat 16%. Muscle ache 14.8%. How many symptomatic people now require oxygen? In India, as of today, 1.75% of the patients were in ICU beds, 0.40% were on ventilator, and 4.03% were occupying oxygen beds. Since the total active cases have now risen to 20,31,977, the number of patients requiring oxygen beds is significant. On Monday, members of the National COVID-19 Task Force said, hospital data shows that a significant 54.5% of hospital admissions during the second wave required supplemental oxygen during treatment. This was a 13.4 percentage point increase compared to the previous wave between September and November. The data from 40 centers across the country shows, however, requirement of mechanical ventilation dropped during the second wave to a 27.8% of admitted patients from 37.3% during the first wave. Dr. Balaram Bhargava, Indian Council of Medical Research, said there is limited data on why more patients are requiring oxygen. This needs to be further studied. This could be explained by the fact that due to the sudden surge of cases, there is a panic. People wanted to get admitted to hospitals, therefore oxygen requirement suddenly shot up. But there is limited data from hospital setting and more will have to be looked at. However, oxygen, an important tool in the management of COVID-19, disease, particularly when oxygen saturation has fallen. In what condition is oxygen used in COVID-19 clinical management? According to clinical management protocol, a person is suffering from moderate disease when he or she is diagnosed with pneumonia with no signs of severe disease, with the presence of clinical feature of dyspnea, shortness of breath, or hypoxia when the body is deprived of adequate oxygen supply at the tissue level. Fever, cough, including SpO2, oxygen saturation level less than 94% in room air. In moderate cases, oxygen therapy is the primary form of treatment. The target is to achieve 92-96% of SpO2 or 80 to The devices for administering oxygen in moderate disease are nasal prongs, masks or masks with breathing, non-breathing reservoir bags, depending on requirement. The protocol also recommends awake proning as a rescue therapy to increase oxygenation. Severe cases are defined in three categories: severe pneumonia, acute respiratory syndrome and sepsis. The clinical management protocol recommends oxygen therapy at 5 liters per minute. When respiratory distress or hypoxemia of the patient cannot be alleviated after receiving standard oxygen therapy, the protocol recommends that high flow nasal cannula oxygen therapy or non-invasive ventilation can be considered. Compared to standard oxygen therapy, high flow nasal cannula oxygen reduces the need for intubation. Patients with hypercapnia, multi-organ failure or abnormal mental status should generally not receive HPOD. So does a patient always show COVID symptoms when their oxygen level drops? No. According to FAQs on COVID-19 from AIIMS, sudden deaths have been reported at presentation to the emergency department as well as in hospital. AIIMS has said that the reasons that have been proposed include a sudden cardiac event preceding silent hypoxia that went unnoticed or due to thrombotic complications such as pulmonary thrombolism. In silent hypoxia, patients have extremely low blood oxygen level yet do not show signs of breathlessness. In patients with silent hypoxia, the amounts of oxygen carried in our blood, otherwise known as blood oxygen. So it recommended that instead of solely relying on pulse oximeter, the patient should monitor for gastrointestinal symptoms, muscle soreness, fatigue and changes in taste and smell, as well as the more common initial symptoms such as fever, cough and shortness of breath. Thank you.